What do you do if you meet the perfect person, but at the wrong time in life? That's the heartbreaking question in this award-winning film from acclaimed director David Lean. Welcome. This time we take a look at personal drama and a tragic romance in 1945's Brief Encounter. Sexual tension and doomed infatuations have created great drama, from Romeo and Juliet to Casablanca, Titanic, Gone with the Wind, and even TV's Moonlighting. Sure, happy endings might be upbeat, but they don't stay with you the same way. Brief Encounter was based on Noel Coward's one-act play, Still Life. It's set in conservative middle-class England, just before the start of World War II. The movie opens with the melodramatic music of Rachmaninoff, which nicely sets the stage. Coward's story takes the happy buzz of romance and turns it on its head by having the couple already locked into mundane marriages with children. The film stars Celia Johnson as Laura Jessen, while Trevor Howard, in his romantic leading man period, plays Dr. Alec Harvey. Their liaison is portrayed in flashbacks, going back to their first chance meeting at a train station tea shop. Laura is a respectable Londoner coming home from her weekly day downtown. When she gets something in her eye, Dr. Harvey comes to her aid. They chat, and then they say goodbye. But the next week, their paths cross again. They chat, innocently, but a bit longer this time. Soon, they begin planning get-togethers, such as lunches or an afternoon at the movies.
Mercy. There's your train.
Yes.
You mustn't miss it.
No.
What's the matter?
Nothing. Nothing at all, really.
It's been so very nice. I've enjoyed my afternoon enormously.
I'm so glad. So have I. I apologize for boring you with long medical words.
I feel dull and stupid not to be able to understand more.
Shall I see you again?
It's the other platform, isn't it? You'll have to run. Don't bother about me. It might not do for a few minutes.
Shall I see you again?
Yes, of course. Perhaps you'll come out to catch with one Sunday. It's rather far, I know, but we should be delighted.
Please. Please.
What is it?
Next Thursday, the same time.
These meetings become increasingly important to both of them, though we mainly see the story through Laura's eyes. She narrates her inner thoughts as she juggles the exhilaration of her weekly escapes with growing despair and the realization that she's falling deeply in love with Alec. A real strong point of Brief Encounter is Johnson's performance and her character's total, sometimes painful, honesty. Her frankness makes her very sympathetic. Her feelings go from giddy innocence to guilt and self-doubt that gets hard to watch.
I'm a happily married woman. Or rather, I was until a few weeks ago. This is my whole world. And it's enough. Or rather, it was until a few weeks ago.
Can I help you?
And of course, Laura and Alec aren't kids. They're mature adults, but still short of middle age. Somehow, that makes the story more poignant, as they deal with issues that will impact the rest of their lives and the lives of family members. Two more points here that make the characters intriguing. Coward's setup puts the couple in a fresh, new relationship, and a new relationship, especially a forbidden one, can be very enticing. As well, each has a realization and gratification of knowing that they're still attractive to a desirable partner. Coward's storyline doesn't make things any easier on them. Laura's husband is a quietly supportive man. He's no monster. And Harvey's wife is also decent, but we never see her on screen. In short, Laura and Alec don't have the emotional convenience of a horrible spouse they need to escape. Instead, they both have accidentally found someone they're more suited to and feel more passionate about. In this respect, it's interesting the film was made and released towards the end of World War II, even though it's set just before the war. The theme of selfless duty eclipsing personal needs and happiness is very strong. Alec and Laura may discuss forming a new life together, but somehow that doesn't seem very likely to happen. And inevitably, the relationship finally reaches a level where they have to decide whether to consummate their passion. Of course, this is very difficult for both of them. I won't discuss what happens here, except to say it differs from the resolution in Coward's play. Brief Encounter was one of four collaborations between Lean and Coward in the mid-1940s. Lean worked on Coward's wartime naval film In Which We Serve. He directed This Happy Breed, about a London family in the interwar years, and the comedy Blithe Spirit. On Brief Encounter, working with cinematographer Robert Crasser, Lean manipulates all the light and shadows of the dark train station to wonderful effect. And, while the man who made Lawrence of Arabia is rightly remembered for his visual style, his films often feature great acting performances. After making Summertime together in the 1950s, Katharine Hepburn loved Lean's approach and described him as, quote, one of the most interesting directors I ever worked with. With Celia Johnson, Brief Encounter featured another strong lead performance by an actress. Johnson was principally a stage actress, but had worked on Lean's earlier film, This Happy Breed. She also played Noel Coward's stalwart wife in Which We Serve. Years later, Lean discussed her on-screen talent. He said, I saw Brief Encounter the other day and thought it was rather good. The magic of that film is Celia Johnson. She was wonderful. Trevor Howard is charming and intelligent as Dr. Harvey, and he's very good in the role. Of course, Howard rose to become a major star by the 1960s, usually playing cranky military officers, so it's fun to see him in romantic parts like this, and in The Passionate Friends, also directed by Lean. In the story, adding to Laura's grief is her acquaintance Dolly Messiter, played with annoying perfection by Everly Gregg. Dolly is a babbling busybody, and she always manages to show up just when Laura has the weight of the world on her shoulders. There's also reliable Stanley Holloway. He's a more welcome distraction as a train station master. In the lighter counterpoint to the main story, Holloway is always flirting with the widow running the station's tea shop. She's played by Joyce Carey. Upon its release, Brief Encounter was a critical success, and it still rates a lofty 8.0 on IMDb today. It was named Best Picture at Cannes. Johnson was named Best Actress by the New York Film Critics, and Lean was nominated for a Best Director Oscar. Always introspective, the film's success surprised Lean, as he summarized. We defied all the rules. There were no big-name stars. There was an unhappy ending to the main love story. The film was played in unglamorous settings, and the three leading characters were approaching middle age. A few years ago, this would have been a recipe for box office disaster, but that wasn't the case with Brief Encounter. Brief Encounter is available on many streaming services and through Criterion DVD. Criterion also offers a very good four-disc set looking at all of the collaborations between Noel Coward and David Lean, which I strongly recommend. I also invite you to comment and subscribe if you haven't already done so, and hope you come back again soon to Waltz, Flicks, Picks.